The suprasebellar infradentorial, as I mentioned before, it is one median, paramedian, lateral, extreme lateral. These are the major approaches we've seen before already. And this is a nice view, for example, I've seen all these approaches in the same different trajectory. So I have the median. This one I had more time when doing my fellowship, do all this animation. I was working a lot on this. But this is a median, paramedian, and extreme lateral. Basically, trajectory is different according to what you're after to. So basically, the region, the collicula, you can see if I have something in the midline, I will go from particularly infradentorial, I'll go to a median approach. If I go a little bit more lateral, I'll go paramedian. And then extreme lateral is something in the perimesencephalic system. Basically, this one will be pretty much corresponding to the retrocingulate, a little bit more superior and more posterior. And this one can be even enhanced with the tentorial cutting. So either I can go even supradentorial or infradentorial, cutting the tentorium to join the two compartments, supra infradentorial. So this is a very nice approach for lateral place lesion, lateral brainstem. Look, this is a very nice view of the entire option, the whole option. And this, the dural cut is pretty much the same as the midline suboccipital. It will be more superior because you're, and that's the one for the, from paramedian and extreme lateral. This is the sitting position, which I don't favor, although in theory, technically is very good because the cerebellar hemispheres are falling down in a way that you open properly because it gives you a little more space, supracerebellar underneath the tentorium. But because of the other complication, because of the awkward position of my arms, my deltoids are going to complain. So I use always the lateral approach, modify. Bringing main, cut the bringing main, understanding the anatomy is difficult. There should be like a lecture only on the anatomy of this approach. But the main point is taking the anatomy. Under magnification of the microscope, the surgeon extends the dissection deeper towards the precentral vein, basically. And it's basically, you need to put a retractor most of the times there, just a single retractor over the roof of the cerebellum. And you can see the precentral vein basically is unsheathed and bioarachnoid and extend to the galleon, the vein of galleon. There are many tributaries to the precentral vein. And this vein should be cauterized and divided in order to be able to just gain access a little bit more deeper. And finally, we have tumor exposure. You can see this is always a sitting position, but you can see the cerebellum is lower. You can push it a little bit less than you should in a different position. You have a very direct unobstructed exposure all the way down to the pineal gland. And then you can see the final exposure after tumor resection, basically.
Hey everyone, Ryan Rad here from neurosurgerytraining.org. If you like that video, subscribe and donate to keep our content available for medical students across the world.